Alf, we'll see you next time on The Chase. Goodbye.
Potato.
This is 7 Sydney Afternoon News with Anne Sanders.
Good afternoon. It's 4 o'clock. These are the stories making headlines. Hundreds of Australians are spending their first of 14 days in quarantine on Christmas Island after being evacuated from China. The coronavirus death toll now stands at 425 people. Barnaby Joyce has failed in his bid to return as leader of the Nationals, Michael McCormack winning a leadership vote this morning. The huge support for families grieving the loss of 4 children killed by an accused drink driver. And the Prime Minister announces a royal commission into the devastating bushfires as state politicians honour those killed. First at 4, hundreds of evacuated Australians, including dozens of children, are starting their 2 weeks of quarantine on Christmas Island. 2 have been sent to Perth after showing symptoms en route, as the government considers a second evacuation flight from Hubei province. Chris Reason is on Christmas Island.
Well, good afternoon. This marathon journey is finally at an end. An aerial evacuation operation that took some 15 hours to finally deliver the Australian evacuees here to Christmas Island and their 14 days quarantine here at the Immigration Detention Centre. The first flight arrived at 9 p.m. last night to rain and lightning. The Airbus Skytracker charter met by ground staff in fully protective clothing and face masks, the stairs wheeled into place, and then they emerged. 72 of the 240 who'd made the trip from Wuhan. In total, 89 of them were children under 16, and many were on this first flight of the mission. Some almost danced to the buses, others looked exhausted. Now, each flight was the same. There were 4 in all, shuttling the evacuees from Exmouth in WA, each time met by a convoy of minibuses before being delivered here into the care of the AusMat medical assistance team inside. And they, of course, will stay with them for the duration of their stay at the IDC. Only one incident during the operation, that in Learmonth. A heavily pregnant woman and her partner had to be medevaced to Perth by the Royal Flying Doctor Service. Authorities deny it was anything, though, to do with coronavirus. Now, today's transfer of evacuees may not be the last to come here. The New Zealanders have now started their own rescue mission and have offered to also collect any Australians who didn't manage to get onto the Qantas flight on Sunday. They're saying they'll deliver them possibly to Brisbane, where they too will be transferred here to Christmas Island and join the people inside there today.
Thank you, Chris. Michael McCormack is still the country's Deputy Prime Minister after surviving a Nationals leadership challenge by Barnaby Joyce. Mr McCormack says he'll continue to work with Mr Joyce and doesn't expect another challenge as politicians gather in Canberra for the first parliamentary sitting day of 2020.
Parliament's traditional start to the year, church. The fear for the Deputy Prime Minister...
Well, I'm going in to pray for regional Australians.
..that he might be about to witness...
I think it's time to go in and say a few prayers.
..the second coming of Barnaby Joyce.
I know how the game works. I know how the deals are done.
The Coalition's leadership duo has already changed 5 times since 2013. Party room fights, a retirement and Barnaby's career crashing into controversy over his relationship with his media advisor and a sexual harassment case. This morning, he asked Nationals colleagues to change the government's top duo a 6th time and reinstate him.
This is not done flippantly. It's done after a lot of soul-searching.
The meeting took 40 minutes.
Leader's position was won by Mr Michael McCormack.
Queensland's David Littleproud, the new deputy after Bridget McKenzie's resignation. So how many votes did Barnaby lose by?
You'll never find out.
The Nationals keep their party room numbers secret. The Joyce tilt, though, did stir one colleague, Matt Canavan, to quit Cabinet and publicly back him. Barnaby Joyce is all but certain now to watch for a second chance to strike. Not that he and others can say as much just yet.
I've shook hands with Barnaby. We're going to move on.
Barnaby Joyce has congratulated Michael McCormack and says the issue is finalised. The Greens' new leadership team joined a climate protest outside Parliament. Their priority?
Working with the community, working with other members of Parliament who want to quit coal and get us to be a zero pollution.
Tim Lester, 7 News.
Bushfire victims and heroes have been remembered and honoured in both the federal and state parliaments today. The Prime Minister calling the disaster Australia's Black Summer, while confirming there will be a Royal Commission. Reporter Alex Hart has more.
Here at New South Wales Parliament, where flags are at half-mast today, and in Canberra, politics has been briefly put to one side as politicians united to reflect on what's been described as Australia's Black Summer. Those who lost their lives were honoured, and there was also applause for those who put their lives on the line to protect others from what has been an unprecedented bushfire crisis.
Nothing can compare to the human toll. Nothing can compare to the lives lost, families broken and thousands without a home.
The toll as it stands now is 33 people killed and around 3,000 homes destroyed Australia-wide.
We do yet not know fully what we have lost because we are still losing it. It's not over. Australia is still burning.
The Prime Minister revealed that former Defence Boss Air Chief Marshal Mark Binskin would lead a Royal Commission. He's also written to state premiers asking for their input on the inquiry.
Our summers are getting longer, drier and hotter. That's what climate change does, and that requires a new responsiveness, resilience and a reinvigorated focus on adaptation.
The PM mentioning climate change while protesters outside federal parliament demanded more action to address it. It was also announced today that all 9 firefighters who have lost their lives during this crisis will be posthumously awarded the National Emergency Medal.
The leafy street where 4 children died at the hands of an alleged drink driver has become a shrine to the young lives lost. Grieving relatives are gathering to pray at the sea of flowers, toys and crosses in Oatlands near Parramatta. Andrew Denny has more.
Well, there has been a constant stream of people coming here to this growing roadside memorial to pay their respects to the 4 children who were killed here on Saturday. Last night here at Oatlands, hundreds turned out as a sign of respect and support for the families dealing with this horrific tragedy. The Abdullah family lost their 13-year-old son, Anthony, and their 2 daughters, 12-year-old Angelina and 8-year-old Sienna. Their cousin, 11-year-old Veronique Saker, was also killed when they were out for an evening walk. They were all mowed down by a ute that had lost control and ran onto the footpath. Police allege 29-year-old Samuel William Davidson was drunk behind the wheel. He is now facing 20 serious charges, including manslaughter. Today, his alleged victims' families returned here, wanting to thank the public for the incredible support that's been shown.
There's been an enormous outpouring of grief and love from the local community right throughout Australia, and we are eternally grateful for the support that we have all received.
How are we going to survive without them? They were my treasure.
Now, police are still awaiting the results of blood tests taken from the driver and haven't ruled out further charges being laid as a result of those. There are also questions being asked about the passenger who was in that car at the time and what he might have known about the state of the driver before they got in and went on that fateful journey.
To breaking news out of the US now, where the first step deciding who will challenge Donald Trump for the White House has been plunged into chaos. Ash Mullaney is there live in Iowa. Hello, Ash. The results have been delayed, so what's going on?
That's the question everyone is asking here tonight, and this is certainly not the way the Democrats or Iowa had planned this night to go. It's past 11 o'clock at night. We were expecting to have almost all the results here in the first Iowa caucus, the first major test for the Democrats looking to take on the White House. Instead, the party has been left red-faced, facing serious questions about where these results are tonight. They are saying that this is the result of quality control, that they are now looking to do a recount. But of course, this has left campaign parties and candidates facing their voters tonight without any solid answers.
Well, it looks like it's going to be a long night, but I'm feeling good.
Thank you so much. So listen, it is too close to call, so I'm just going to tell you what I do know.
You won!
So, Ash, is there any suggestion a hack may be to blame?
Well, look, there's no doubt, Anne, the Trump team is absolutely loving this tonight. His campaign manager has already asked on Twitter whether this is rigged. The Democratic Party here in Iowa has denied that there is any suggestion of hacking, but that they are doing this recount. There are serious questions, though, about why there has been this significant delay after months of campaigning, millions of dollars having been spent here in Iowa. And we know that Joe Biden's legal team has just recently sent an email to the Democratic Party demanding answers for what he has described as considerable flaws in the caucus here tonight. Anne?
Ashley Mullaney, live in Iowa. Thank you very much, Ash. The Reserve Bank has kept interest rates on hold at a record low of 0.75%. Meeting for the first time this year, the board said the outlook for the global economy looks reasonable, but it did concede that bushfires and the coronavirus outbreak will slow growth in the short term. Women's fashion retailer Colette has collapsed, going into voluntary administration. 140 stores and more than 300 jobs around the country are now on the line, with Deloitte administrators trying to find a way to salvage the business. It's the fourth major retail collapse in the last few months alone. Meteorologist David Brown joins us now. Afternoon, Brownie. Oh, refreshing and cool today. How lovely.
Yes, indeed, and rather cloudy too, following the city's coolest night in about 4 weeks. Now, around the state, well, look, it's been fine apart from some showers and the odd storm just popping up over the northeast corner this afternoon. The latest satellite data highlights, well, a trough that extends all the way from Queensland through our state towards the Victorian border. The trough is expected to strengthen this week, leading to this. Extensive showers and storms for several days, just feeding on humid air that continues to stream in from the Tasman Sea. 5 day totals look like this. Can you believe it? We're expecting something like 50 to 100 millimetres in our backyard. More along parts of the ranges and more again along large areas of the north coast. Of course, totals like this, which are in excess of 200 millimetres, usually leads to flash flooding. But right now, it's clear across the Sydney Basin, 22 degrees in Camden, a little bit cooler in Liverpool. It's 21 degrees, cooler again high in the Blue Mountains, 18 degrees at Katoomba. 7 day forecast in detail and top of the hour.
Thanks, Brownie. Still to come in Sydney's afternoon news on 7, the laws to be rushed through UK Parliament after another attack by a recently released terrorist. And the clapping seal, why he does it, and the researchers that are amazed.
We're back, and look what's new. Charlie's joining the team to make your garden better.
It's everything you love.
And loads of new ideas.
Better food.
Better pets.
Better gardens.
Better health.
Better design.
You won't want to miss it.
New Better Homes and Gardens starts Friday on 7.
When you're with PowerShop, you can feel proud of your power. Because not only is your power 100% carbon offset, it helps fund renewables like wind. PowerShop. Power you can be proud of.
Built to carry the clan. Designed for the ones in charge. Luxury for your world and theirs. New Mazda CX-9.
You want to break limits, break the mold, and break free. But have you got the bones to do it? 73% of Australian women don't get enough calcium from their diet alone. Boost calcium absorption with Austolin Vitamin D, Australia's number one bone health brand. Have you got the bones to do it? Test yourself at dtest.com.au.
With Australian Super, it's my small, simple actions combined with the expert help I get that has grown my money in ways I never could alone. I guess that's why they've made so much money for members for so long.
It's Australian, it's super, and it's yours.
The Pope Auto Wind hose reel has an industry-leading rewind system, a stop-and-go action, a 180-degree swivel, and a 10-year hose warranty. So no more messy backyards. Pope. Smoother. Safer. Better.
Now, mate.
New AeroGuard fabric spray. Goes on clothes, not on skin.
I need a dollar, 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 what
a little
need.
Goes a long way at Macca's. Share 24 chicken McNuggets with your mate. Just $9.95 every day.
GI for longer lasting energy. Wonder Active. Play on.
5,000 years of culture in one performance. Shen Yun. Coming to Capitol Theater March 4th through the 22nd. Tickets at shenyun.com.
You're watching 7's 4pm news. It was a cooler start across the city. This was Cronulla today with some clouds lingering. Right now it's 22 degrees. After another violent attack carried out by a recently released terrorist, the British government is to overhaul its system of parole. Currently, those convicted of terror offences are automatically freed halfway through their sentence. Hugh Whitfeld has more from London.
After two terror attacks carried out by two convicted terrorists who were allowed out of jail under a policy of automatic early release, there is now huge pressure on Boris Johnson's government. His Justice Secretary telling the House of Commons there will be emergency legislation rushed through Parliament to keep terrorists locked up for longer and for their cases to go before a parole board hearing. Remarkably, that doesn't happen right now. Boris Johnson was meant to be giving a speech today about Brexit. It was sidetracked by the terror attack in South London where two people were stabbed.
We do think it's time to take action to ensure that people, irrespective of the law that we're bringing in, people in the current stream do not qualify automatically for early release.
The attacker in Streatham, 20-year-old Sadesh Aman, described today by his mother as a nice, polite boy, but we do know that he was convicted of 13 terror offences, and no one really knows what to do with all of these terrorists locked up in jail, because a rehabilitation and de-radicalisation programs here clearly are not working.
A pair of shootings in the US has left three people dead and several others now fighting for their lives. One attack happened inside a residential hall in a Texas university, with two people shot dead and a two-year-old child injured. While passengers on a Greyhound coach travelling from Los Angeles to San Francisco were ambushed by a fellow traveller who opened fire on board, killing one and injuring five more. Torrential rain has lashed Milford Sound, the popular tourist destination on New Zealand's South Island. The rain washed away a major road into the region, trapping dozens of tourists. Emergency crews are working to evacuate those still there, with more storms closing in right now. A seal has been filmed delivering a performance that truly deserves a round of applause. Experts were left scratching their heads after it was spotted clapping underwater. It's believed the sound is to attract females, but scientists are still unsure exactly how the animal managed to make such a loud clapping noise while submerged. Yeah. Coming up after the break, the staggering amount of evidence police have gathered against the man who terrorised Sydney. And in sport with Jim Wilson, the launch of rugby league's jewel in the crown, but will Adelaide embrace Origin?
Tonight on 7 News with Mark Ferguson.
Inside Christmas Island as Australians arrive from China, Barnaby Joyce's failed leadership bid, and customers offered cash to switch banks.
Tonight on 7 News at 6.
Paying you $4,000 to switch banks as the banks battle for your business. Are their cashbacks a good deal? On 7 News tonight.
Isn't it funny how different our kids are? The way they do things their own way. Luckily, Tip Top has a range of bread that has all the fibre, vitamins and minerals they need. In white, wholemeal and kids' grains. Tip Top, the one for everyone.
The Melody. It sleeps up to 9. Well, sort of. Makes the perfect hiding spot. And also happens to be a very comfortable queen-size bed. Find your fantastic in-store or online today.
Mr. Jewell, did you plant a bomb in Centennial Park?
My son is innocent.
I report the facts.
You've ruined this man's life.
I didn't do this.
We put Vanish to the test by sending influencer Mel Watts something she's always wanted.
Love it.
Covered in a tough stain.
Is that red wine? I mean, I could try and do a hot wash, but it will ruin the dress.
Half a scoop cold water.
I don't know. It's a pretty bad stain. We can give it a go. It is actually working. I can't even see where the stain was.
For amazing results, just cold wash with Vanish Oxy Action.
I need a dollar.
A little goes a long way at Macca's. Share 24 Chicken McNuggets with your mate. Just $9.95 every day.
Days ago, John had muscle pain. Then he discovered Voltaren Emyl Gel. It relieves pain 2 times faster and reduces inflammation to help get you moving sooner. So the game is always on. Voltaren, the joy of movement.
Installation simple. You just plug in.
And play.
Experience Viking, the thinking person's cruise. Explore the world in comfort on our award-winning ships with no kids and no casinos, more time in port, included shore excursions, resident historians, and all-inclusive value makes Viking the discerning traveler's cruise line.
Viking's Explorer sale now on. Save up to $4,000 per couple. Call 138747 or see your Viking travel agent.
Mert Ney, the man accused of murdering a young woman in a Sydney apartment before going on a stabbing rampage through the CBD last year, has faced court this morning. The court heard prosecutors have compiled a staggering amount of evidence against him. 21 folders full of information they hope will keep him behind bars for as long as possible. He'll be back in court at the end of the month. Time for sport now. Jim Wilson and the Aussies name their one-day squad.
It's a strong squad, but a couple of notable absentees, Anne. Good afternoon to you. Afternoon, everyone. Despite being named player of the Big Bash tournament, Marcus Stoinis has been snubbed by Aussie selectors this afternoon. But the big show is back in the fold. Glenn Maxwell has been recalled to both the T20 and one-day sides for the South Africa tour.
Get mentally right to perform and play well without any sort of mental scars or anything like that sort of going behind, and just be able to concentrate on the things that actually matter.
The world's best spinner, Nathan Lyon, was overlooked for both limited overs squads yet again, and Daniel Sam's Big Bash leading 30 wickets wasn't enough for a call-up.
It's always been a dream of mine, ever since I was a kid. Playing for Australia would be
would be awesome.
Sams and the Sydney Thunder flew to Melbourne today for Thursday night's clash with the Stars. The winner faces the Sydney Sixers in Saturday night's grand final at the SCG that you'll see right here on 7. Rugby League State of Origin series was launched today in Adelaide with Game 1 to be played in the South Australian capital. Chief League reporter Michelle Bishop is in Adelaide as the Blues look to make it 3 series wins in a row.
Good afternoon, Jim. Latrell Mitchell wasn't a part of the Blues squad that coach Brad Fittler got together over the weekend, but he has stressed that he's still very much up for selection for the 2020 State of Origin series. He's at a new club, of course, South Sydney, under the guidance of one of the game's greatest mentors in Wayne Bennett, and in a new position that he claims will challenge him again.
He just wanted to burn in love with the game. I think when he's in love with the game, he's outstanding, he's hard to stop, whether he's playing fullback, 5-8 or centres.
Jim, it's a significant step for rugby league here in Adelaide, which is traditionally AFL heartland. Game 1, the opener, here at the iconic Adelaide Oval on June 3. Both Fittler and Queensland coach Kevin Walters feel Game 1 is a must win.
Game 1 is always so important, and what a great way to kick off the State of Origin than playing at Adelaide Oval.
Every game's important at State of Origin level. And where we play that game is irrelevant. It's exciting to be coming here, sure.
Now, tickets to Game 1 go on sale to the general public tomorrow. And despite this being AFL territory, organisers are expecting a capacity crowd of 53,000 fans. And it'll be the first time that locals get to taste State of Origin. Jim.
Thank you, Michelle. We'll have more from Michelle in 7 News at 6 o'clock. The Giants say they love being the sole Sydney team in the AFLW Premiership. It's now a 14-team competition with Richmond, St Kilda, West Coast and the Gold Coast to debut this year. Greater Western Sydney opened their campaign against the Suns in Blacktown on Saturday.
We really embrace being that sole team in Sydney for the moment, and it's fantastic how much support we do get.
Yep, go the Giants. The season begins on Friday night with Richmond against Carlton, live and free on 7 Mate. The Matildas are confident skipper Sam Kerr will overcome a leg injury in time for the start of their Olympic qualifying campaign. Kerr trained with the Aussies for the first time this afternoon ahead of the opening group game against Chinese Taipei at Campbelltown Stadium on Friday night.
There's no fear that we can't win without her. We just want to win as a team, whether she's with us or not. But hopefully she is with us, and I think she will be fit and healthy.
Chinese Taipei got its campaign off to a flyer last night with an upset 1-0 win over Thailand. Mustang star Scott McLaughlin says he's primed for his shot at a third consecutive Supercars Championships. The 2020 season was launched against the backdrop of the Harbour Bridge today. After several controversial incidents last year, McLaughlin knows there's a target on his head.
Well, we're primed, ready to go to have a big crack at it. Obviously, everyone's going to be coming out swinging the first couple of rounds, so we need to make sure that we get a good few points on the board at the start.
What an absolute superstar. The season begins in Adelaide in just over a fortnight. The Super Bowl celebrations are in full swing for the Kansas City Chiefs. MVP Patrick Mahomes, the architect of the comeback win over the San Francisco 49ers, was front and centre at a parade at Disney World in Florida. Chiefs coach Andy Reid was asked if he spent the night with the famous Lombardi Trophy.
I didn't really sleep last night. But I didn't spend it with a trophy. Well, I did. I spent it with my trophy wife. How's that?
Okay. Andy and wife Tammy have been married for 38 years. We'll have more on the State of Origin launch in 7 News at 6 o'clock. Game 1, Adelaide. Game 2, Sydney. Game 3, Brisbane. We love Origin.
Bring it on. Thank you.
Thanks, Ed.
This afternoon's top stories are next, including the latest on the coronavirus outbreak and the fast-tracked hospital taking infected patients. The Uniting Church Minister accused of the historic assault of a teenager. The multi-billion dollar metro blowout and what's behind it. Plus, the frightening attacks on hospital staff and what doctors say is driving it. And why Heston Blumenthal is in hot water.
Will you marry me?
I'd be honoured.
It's going to be amazing, Mr. Stewart.
Thanks, Marilyn. This is it, Grubbs. You ready?
You know we belong together.
You were my first love, and I want you to be my last.
You're invited to something very special. Home and Away, this week on 7.
Liven up your lunch with Tip Top Sandwich Thins. They're super soft and light, and each one is only 99 calories. So you can enjoy a softer, lighter lunch. Now available in Tip Top Burger Thins.
When you're working hard, you need a boot that's comfortable all day. DeWalt Pro Comfort Boots, with a unique shock-absorbing inner sole and high-rebound midsole for all-day comfort. Get the job done with DeWalt Pro Comfort Boots. Available at Bunnings Warehouse.
When you're with PowerShop, you can feel proud of your power. Because not only is your power 100% carbon offset, it helps fund renewables, like wind. PowerShop. Power you can be proud of.
Here's the deal, Quinn.
You need me!
I'm the one they should be scared of.
It was time for Gotham to meet the new Harley Quinn.
Harley Quinn and Birds of Prey, in cinemas Thursday.
She loves cats, so tonight I'll borrow my neighbor's.
My babies.
Temptations Cat Treats.
More than 200 Australians are settling in on Christmas Island right now. These are pictures just into the newsroom from the quarantine zone, where two more flights have arrived. The people you're seeing are now facing lengthy quarantine checks after being evacuated from the epicentre of the coronavirus outbreak, as the death toll continues to rise.
They said they would do it, and now they have. A massive hospital equipped with operating theatres, an emergency room and 1,000 beds, built from scratch in just over a week. This is China's answer to the coronavirus outbreak, and even by the country's swift construction record, it's quite a feat. These pictures from Chinese state media show it fully equipped and furnished, the government eager to prove they have the upper hand. But on the streets of the outbreak epicentre, it's a very different story. A girl's screams of anguish echo through a car park. Inside this minibus, the body of her mother. She calls out to her as she's driven away. Far from the carefully controlled information the government is releasing, the situation inside Wuhan is deteriorating rapidly. Pinned to the ground and doused in chemicals, in a city gripped by fear, this is the vigilante justice dished out to anyone caught walking around without a mask. As the nation's economy continues to take a battering from the outbreak, it's not just China trying to win the confidence of the community. Despite only two reported cases in a nation home to 145 million, Russia has ordered the immediate deportation of anyone found to have the disease. A dramatic response to a crisis that's now become as much about controlling the narrative as the spread of infection. Christian Gapset, 7 News.
A former defence chief has been named as the Prime Minister's choice to lead a royal commission into the bushfire crisis. Air Chief Marshal Mark Binskin is a front runner to head up the inquiry into the horror season, which Scott Morrison has referred to as our Black Summer.
That's the story of a summer. Remarkable Australians standing by each other, struggling, persevering, taking the wins where they could find them.
The Prime Minister has written to state premiers and chief ministers seeking feedback on draft terms of reference the inquiry will examine. After a dramatic false start yesterday, today the trial got underway for the former lead detective in the William Tyrrell case. Gary Jubelin has pleaded not guilty to illegally recording conversations with a person related to the case. His lawyer argued against the police commissioner's request to suppress certain details. She said it could make Mr. Jubelin a scapegoat for the failed investigation, The magistrate declared substantial matters in the hearing could be heard in open court. A former Uniting Church minister has been supported by his wife as he appeared in court today, accused of sex offences dating back more than three decades. Ron Brookman entered a not guilty plea over the alleged assault on a 13-year-old boy. Marley Hogan reports.
A former reverend has appeared in court charged with historical child sexual offences. Ron Charles Brookman arrived at Newtown Local Court this morning with supporters, including his wife. He was smiling, calm, and greeted waiting media.
Good day.
Good morning.
The 70-year-old is accused of indecently assaulting a 13-year-old boy in 1989. Brookman was a senior minister of the Uniting Church in Newtown at the time of the alleged assault. Today, his lawyer entered a plea of not guilty on his behalf. Do you believe you are innocent?
Of course.
The 70-year-old retired from his official religious duties and went on to promote conversion therapy, claiming to help people heal from broken sexuality. According to his LinkedIn account, he now runs sexual addiction recovery programs in the Ramsgate and Sutherland areas. Do you still believe in conversion therapy?
I never have. That is a media beat-up.
The 70-year-old remains on bail and will be back in court next month to fight the charge.
The Metro Rail project is going to cost at least $4 billion more than what the government planned for. An internal review, which was leaked, has found cost blowouts across many parts of the city and southwest sections of the project are to blame. The biggest issues, new trains, excavation work at Martin Place and Barangaroo, and the rework at Central. The driverless metro is scheduled to be completed by 2024. Heston Blumenthal is the latest celebrity chef to be exposed for underpaying his staff. His high-end restaurant, Dinner by Heston, opened in 2015 at Crown Casino in Melbourne and owes more than $4 million. Here's Melina Saris.
Heston Blumenthal was the face of the restaurant, but the union is accusing Crown of playing a part in underpaying the workers. Carlos and Angela were both chefs at Dinner by Heston. They say they're owed up to $25,000 in lost wages and often used to work around 70 hours a week.
The hours that we worked was ridiculous, so we definitely should get what we deserve.
15-hour days, only like half an hour break. Sometimes finish around like 1:30 in the morning. Next day we come at 7 in the morning.
A report shows in total employees are owed around $4.5 million, but it has also revealed how the restaurant was being run. Dinner by Heston opened at Crown in 2015. The union says it was a joint venture between Crown Melbourne and an offshore company called Tipsy Cake. They paid Crown just $1 a year in rent and Crown took a share of the profits.
This is shocking corporate collusion between Dinner by Heston and Crown. Crown was part of creating this problem and they have to take responsibility for fixing it.
Crown has denied it was in a joint venture with Tipsy Cake and has said it will assist employees who are now looking for work. Dinner by Heston was placed into voluntary administration last month and on Friday, Crown gave the restaurant 14 days to vacate the premises. This is the latest in a string of high-profile restaurants accused of underpaying its workers, including Shannon Bennett, Rockpool, George Columbaris and Burger Chain Grilled.
Queensland's shark control program has undergone a massive shake-up today. New technology, including smart drum lines, will be rolled out at one of the nation's most popular holiday destinations. The government is confident it'll still keep tourists safe while also killing fewer sharks. Erin Edwards reports.
Well, catch and kill is largely over, but only on the Great Barrier Reef Marine Park, which is an area roughly the same size as Germany. Queensland has been forced to make these changes after the Humane Society took the state's shark control program to a tribunal. 173 drum lines pulled out 5 months ago will be redeployed. This time, they'll have to be checked every day instead of every second day. And all sharks will have to be freed if the shark is healthy and it is safe.
The Palaszczuk government has no higher priority than ensuring the safety of human life.
They'll also be tagged, but there is no technology right now which will allow swimmers to track them. This is all happening in an area which includes the Whitsundays, a tourist mecca where there have been 6 shark attacks in 14 months.
We're entering their environment, so it's swim at your own risk.
The federal government has given Queensland $4 million to make the changes from lethal to non-lethal shark control. This includes money for trials of drone surveillance and smart drum lines like those trialled in New South Wales and WA. All of this is only in the marine park, which stretches from Bundaberg to Cape York. The rest of the state, like the Sunshine and Gold Coasts, is still protected by drum lines and nets, which is criticised by many as being inhumane and technology from the 1930s.
Next in 7's afternoon news, the intense flames that consumed a factory in the southwest and the frightening video of hospital staff being attacked. What's behind the violence? And it's 21 degrees in Campbelltown. Brownie has Sydney's forecast soon.
I can't believe I'm telling you this. It is, it's huge. I can hear it.
Sounds like a jet engine.
Have you ever seen a fire like this?
Never.
The last word you said, I promise I'll be safe.
Those that work under me saved the lives of many.
I'm right.
I'm a very proud captain.
Australia has seen a lot of bushfires. We have never seen anything like this.
Hellfire, the 7 News event, tonight, 9 o'clock.
Introducing Macca's delicious new McVeggie Burgers with a crunchy potato, cheese and veggie patty, fresh lettuce, creamy mayo and our famous pickles. Now there truly is something for everyone.
We need to save for a bigger place.
She makes me feel like financing.
I feel like financing.
It feels good to set a savings goal. Search ANZ Financial Wellbeing.
They call me Hal. They call me Stacey. They call me Her. They call me Jane. That's not my niche. That's not my niche. That's not my niche. That's not so long, all the time.
Olay was put to the ultimate MRI test. The MRI proved Olay intensely hydrates your skin for a plumper, firmer, and more radiant glow. See the results in 28 days. Olay.
Terry and Susan have been together 12 years, but all good things come to an end.
Ooh. If you love something, you gotta let it go.
For an extensive range, you can count on Kenner's Hire.
They call me Hal. They call me Stacey. They call me Her. They call me Jane. That's not my niche. That's not my niche. That's not my niche. That's not so long all the time.
You're doing great. That's it.
When it comes to having a baby, there's
We're
care.
Almost there. Almost there.
And there's the uncommon care you get with HCF. Now in partnership with Sydney Adventist Hospital.
And now there's 3 of us.
For Australia's first no-gap pregnancy cover. So you get the quality care that's right for you and your family with no out-of-pocket costs. As Australia's largest not-for-profit health fund, we put people before profit. That's uncommon care.
The bestest picnic ever.
Mum and Gran will be there.
And Tommy's there, but he's a koala.
Then Dad can ride in on a unicorn.
No, a piece of corn.
And there's cupcakes and magical fairies.
And yummy sandwiches, but not any sandwiches. Gigantic sandwiches.
And it starts raining fairy bread.
Yeah!
That would be awesome.
Meadow Lee.
That was a disaster.
What unfolds will leave every contestant stunned. New The Chase, weekdays on 7.
A ferocious factory fire has consumed large parts of a building in Punchbowl and sent smoke into surrounding suburbs. It forced the closure of Canterbury Road, with firefighters taking around an hour to bring it under control. No one was inside at the time. Startling new video has revealed the dangers emergency ward staff face on a daily basis. One hospital in Melbourne has found that when its staff are attacked and drugs are involved, the violence is almost always carried out by people high on ice. Laurel Irving has more.
This was a world first trial here at the Royal Melbourne Hospital, using the same drug test that police use on the roads to test patients here who are violent or aggressive towards staff, particularly in the emergency department. And the scale of the problem is extraordinary. You can see in the vision released by the hospital, there are 10 code greys, so-called code greys, where help has to be called because of violent or aggressive behaviour by patients just at the Royal Melbourne every day. This test means that within 10 minutes, staff know exactly what they're dealing with. And the trial found that of all the patients who are aggressive or threatening, 40% of them are on drugs. And of those people, 92% are on ice.
Being able to have a test readily available that really determines yes or no makes our management of that patient a lot better.
So now we have the results of this initial trial. The question becomes what to do with this information, and hospitals will start to formulate strategies to deal with these patients, and it may well be that these drug wipes become a permanent fixture in Victoria's hospitals.
Thanks, Laurel. Checking finance now with James Tower, ComSec. Hello, James. The Reserve Bank has left interest rates on hold this afternoon. How's our market responded?
Yeah, very good afternoon to you. And it was a much improved session for the Aussie market. Today, the ASX 200 up around 25 points, just shy of 6,950 points. And as you mentioned, it was widely tipped that the RBA would keep rates on hold today. And there was some rather upbeat commentary to come through as well. So the RBA only expecting a temporary dip in the economic growth story following the bushfires and the ongoing coronavirus outbreak as well. So we saw retailing stocks among some of the biggest improvers. Harvey Norman today jumping close to 6% on several broker upgrades. JB Hi-Fi also lifting around 3.5%. The buy now, pay later firm Afterpay lifting close to 5%. But we did see a bit of a mixed performance from our banks and some weakness from energy stocks. The Aussie dollar had a pretty strong session as well, and it's just shy of 67.2 US cents.
James Tower from ComSec. Thank you, James. Sydney 6pm News is coming up with Mark Ferguson. Hello, Mark. What are you working on in the newsroom?
Yeah, hello there, Anne. Coming up tonight, a New Zealand government chartered flight on its way to China, set to collect another group of Australians trapped in Wuhan. At 6, we'll take you behind the quarantine centre walls as the first group of evacuees arrived on Christmas Island. Also, Sydney terror threat, why there are calls for this former actor to be closely monitored. Barnaby Joyce fails, his attempt at a spill unsuccessful, but should Nationals leader Michael McCormack be expecting another challenge? A state of emergency declared on New Zealand's South Island, the latest on a catastrophic weather event that has left hundreds of tourists stranded. And beware the lure of quick cash. Customers are being offered thousands to change banks. What you need to know before making that switch. And all the details, Sydney 7 News tonight at 6 o'clock.
See you then, Fogo. Thank you. Let's get a check now on Sydney's traffic.
Good afternoon, I'm Alex Straughan of the Gerard Maloof and Partners Skytracker 7 chopper at East Lakes. Outbound traffic on Southern Cross Drive toward the M5 tunnels, getting on the move following an earlier multi-vehicle that's been cleared. We're currently hovering above Granville. This is the outbound run on Parramatta Road. As you can see, both lanes are struggling with delays going back into the Clyde area. Looking for your fair share in a will or estate? Make the right choice. Call Gerard Maloof and Partners on 1-800-00-HURT and ask about their 90-day risk-free trial.
Today is World Cancer Day, and men across the country are being urged to get online and find out whether they're at risk of developing prostate cancer. A new survey from the Prostate Foundation of Australia asks a series of questions aimed at telling men their risk factor. The survey only takes 10 minutes, and experts say could save your life. And the Cancer Council says there are plenty of things we can all do to reduce our risk of cancer. They include eating a balanced and nutritious diet, including 5 serves of vegetables and 2 servings of fruit a day, avoid excessive exposure to the sun, and wearing sunscreen and protective clothing. Maintaining a healthy weight with at least 30 minutes of physical activity a day. Limit your alcohol consumption and don't smoke. An Australian tech startup has made a critical breakthrough in the treatment of type 1 diabetes and now is in the running for one of the world's major medical prizes. Steve Titmus explains.
Those behind the breakthrough are based here at the University of Queensland. They say they have created the bionic pancreas. Leading the challenge is a tech startup called Team Machine Genes. Founder Dr. Nigel Greenwood has been working on the breakthrough for 29 years.
So what they really need is some form of artificial intelligence to tell them how to dose their insulin better. Problem is, that is really hard.
Machine Genes has created computer software that enables analysis of a type 1 diabetic's medical history. It takes that information and, using artificial intelligence, it redesigns the individual insulin dosage.
So the net result out of this is you get an app running on an iPad that suggests what your insulin strategy should be, and it's been rigorously tested before it comes to you.
Machine Genes and their artificial intelligence software are a semi-finalist in the Watson AI X Prize, the Nobel Prize of the med tech world.
This is going to be a complete game changer for so many wonderful young and old people.
A win for Machine Genes will snare $4 million, enabling clinical trials to begin at Westmead in Sydney this year. The target is to have commercially available treatments by 2025.
The kind of alarm tone you wake up to could play a big part in how you feel for the rest of the day. A study has found that the beeping sound from a standard alarm clock is linked to grogginess. Researchers believe the harsh sounds confuse our brain, which means it takes longer to properly wake up. Good news is, more melodic sounds or music are associated with increased alertness. Next in 7's Afternoon News, cooler conditions roll in. How long will they stick around for? Brownie's back with the forecast.
Australia's biggest week of sport this year is here. Thursday, the Challenger Final decides who will make the Big Bash Grand Final.
Oh, God!
Friday, AFLW kicks off with a blockbuster clash.
A huge kick!
Then, Saturday, India test our Aussie champs in the Women's T20.
That is amazing!
Then, Warn, Ponte, leading the who's who of cricket for the Bushfire Bash. Then, the massive Big Bash Grand Final.
What a way to finish it!
Australia's biggest week of sport this year starts Thursday on 7.
It's a race against time, comparing all your flight choices. Sam's visiting each airline site separately and knows how fast special deals can sell out. Cindy's gone straight to Webjet, where she can instantly see all her options, book the best value airfare, get her booking price guaranteed, and still earn frequent flyer points. It's time to make your own way in the world with Webjet.
When it comes to overseas holidays, there are the mass-produced bargain tours, and then there's Bunnick Tours. Because we design our tours for smaller groups, we can offer so much more. Maybe that's why we've just been named International Tour Operator of the Year.
Land Rover sales season brings with it an unprecedented $20,000 worth of extras on the special edition Land Rover Discovery. Seasons change, some change better than others.
Isn't it funny how different our kids are? The way they do things their own way. Luckily, Tip Top has a range of bread that has all the fibre, vitamins and minerals they need. In white, wholemeal and kids' grains. Tip Top, the one for everyone.
Introducing Macca's delicious new McVeggie Burgers with a crunchy potato, cheese and veggie patty, fresh lettuce, creamy mayo and our famous pickles. Now there truly is something for everyone.
When choosing paracetamol to relieve pain, it's important to know not all are the same. Panadol with Optizorb has an advanced formula to deliver paracetamol more efficiently and be absorbed faster. Imagine this is your stomach and this vinegar, your stomach acid. Watch how Panadol with Optizorb's patented delivery system goes to work.
Panadol Optizorb, fast and effective pain relief that's gentle on the stomach.
Available at your pharmacy or supermarket. This has been Medifax for Panadol with Optizorb.
We all like open plan designs, but sometimes wouldn't it be nice to zone off areas for a home theatre, study area, or an occasional bedroom? Come and see Zone Living Solutions at a Doors Plus near you.
Doors Plus?
No fuss.
That was, frankly, a disaster.
What will unfold that will leave every contestant...
What's happened here today?
Stunned. The Chase, weekdays at 5 on 7.
I can't believe I'm telling you this. I wish it wasn't true.
It is, it's huge, I can hear it.
Sounds like a jet engine.
Have you ever seen a fire like this?
Never. No man on earth could survive that.
The last words he said, I promise I'll be safe.
Those that work under me saved the lives of many.
I'm right.
I'm a very proud captain.
I wanted to be able to do something.
Australia has seen a lot of bushfires. We have never seen anything like this.
Hellfire, the 7 News event, tonight, 9 o'clock.
David's here with the latest forecast. Hello, Brownie. How's the rest of the week shaping up?
Well, and what I can say, tomorrow's looking good as our coolest day in almost, well, 3 weeks draws to a close. In fact, the top was 24 degrees. That happened just a few minutes after midday, as you can see. And by the way, it's about 2 degrees below average. Right now, current conditions around our state. It's sitting on 24 degrees in Orange, a little bit warmer in Tamworth to the north, 29 degrees. Further north in Coffs Harbour, 21 degrees. Latest satellite data highlights cloudy conditions along most of the coast at the moment. Got some storms going off across the northern ranges. It's been a sunny day. In fact, it's still clear, well, generally clear once you get west of the Great Dividing Range. But falling pressure to the north tomorrow will lead to showers and thunderstorms developing. You can see them just sweeping in from the Sunshine State. The heaviest rain will be confined to Queensland at this stage. It will change as we get, well, as we progress throughout the week. But tomorrow in Brisbane, drenching rain, the forecast top of around 25 degrees. Melbourne, fine and, well, mostly sunny. Coolish too, around 22 degrees. That's around 2 below average for this time of year. Warmer day is expected in Adelaide. Forecast top of 28 degrees. Perth should be sunny with that maximum climbing up towards 35 degrees. For the city, remaining fine. A warm top of 26 degrees is on the way, coming off an overnight low there of around 19. The comfort guy will enjoy Wednesday. But as for the next 7 days, showers and storms starting to build. I think that'll happen during Thursday afternoon. Similar conditions to unfold on Friday. Rainfall rate starting to pick up. Heavy rain is likely. Heavy rain at times, that is, across the weekend. And, of course, with totals like this, we'll probably see some local flash flooding, and then the rain is easing to showers and again some storm activity during the early part of next week. So that's the latest weather, and of course I'll have more details at 6 o'clock.
Thank you very much, Brownie. And that is Sydney's 4 p.m. news for this Tuesday. Mark Ferguson will have our next bulletin at 6 o'clock. I'm Ann Sanders. Stay with 7 now for the Chase Australia, and I'll see you tomorrow. Have a great night.